Hi there everyone, welcome back to Infinity Drones. Please excuse the mess on my desk, but today we can take a look at how you can upgrade your DJI goggles version 1 or version 2 with the DroneHacks application. And the reason for this is that you want to bypass the DJI assistant for FPV application, because that is where you could potentially get force updated. Now, the reason we want to do this as well is typically if you have a DJI FPV drone and you want to load the DroneHacks mod, then you need to have your goggles on the latest firmware version, which is ends with 0.15. But there's lots of reasons a lot of guys do not want to have that version. And you can see I've got two goggles here so that I don't run on the latest version. If you run that latest version, you are going to lose the root exploit option, which means you cannot root your goggles. But for a lot of guys, that's not really something that they really worry about. Especially if you're flying the DJI FPV drone only, then there's no need for it. So with the DJI FPV drone, you want to have DroneHacks loaded, because then you remove the altitude limit as well as the no-fly zones, and FCC mode will be permanently enabled. So what you do is you go to your browser, and you're going to go to the DroneHacks website. Typically you'll see it's just DroneHacks, drone-hacks.com. And once you've opened that one, you typically go straight to the bird map to see which drones are supported. Now over here, as per all my other videos, you guys are always need to go to the bird map to see what DJI drones are supported. In this case, you're gonna see the DJI FPV Racer. Once again, the most stupid marketing ever. They should never have loaded that version. But in any case, your DJI FPV drone needs to be on this version. However, your DJI FPV goggles needs to be on this version. Okay, so don't worry about it. You can always just do it inside the goggles or via the DJI Fly app or whatever you need to do it. It doesn't make a difference, but I prefer using the DroneHacks application purely because I want to be in control. I don't want DJI doing anything that I am not aware of. And also it's a pain in the butt because you have to have an internet connection. With the way I'm gonna show you now, you don't need to have an internet connection. You can actually download the files offline, and whenever you need to, you can actually just flash the firmware offline or online, whatever you want to. So in this case, you can see we've got this over here, but what we need is we need to have the DroneHacks application. So click on downloads, click on DJI, doesn't make a difference really, because we're using DJI goggles, we probably want to use that. Whatever operating system you use, please note it does not support Mac. You will need to have a Windows 10, and in some cases Windows 11 is starting to work, but we don't support that 100% yet. So there we go, and you can just click on download. Now, once you've downloaded the application, it's going to run very quick. It's a very small application. You can open the application. I've already downloaded it. Let me just open it. And then you can log in. Now, if you haven't created an account yet, it's quite simple. Just go straight up and you can go create account. You do not need to buy a license, okay? You don't need to have a license. However, you're most likely going to mod your DJI FPV drone with a DroneHacks license to remove the altitude limits, so you're most likely going to have an account. If you don't, just go and sign up. It's extremely easy to do, okay? So once that's done, you can then open the application itself, and then the application will automatically start searching for any potential drones that could be connected, or goggles in this case. So the first thing I'm gonna do is, this goggles over here is on the old version, this goggles here is on the new version. So let me just power up this latest DJI FPV goggles over here. So let me just power it up. While it's powering up, I'm going to take my USB port and then connect it to the actual goggle. Now, this goggles over here is on the latest firmware, meaning we cannot downgrade it. What happens is when if you upgrade to a certain version, there is anti-rollback version number that gets increased. As you can see over here, my goggles have now been detected, and it even shows my firmware version over here. However, here it says, I can't hack it because it's not a drone. So I need to connect a drone to the PC for DroneHacks to actually mod it. In this case, we don't care about that. But here's the thing, no upgrade in progress, normal login, everything is now fine. My goggles have been detected. If I wanna go to the firmware section, which is great, just click on the firmware section. I can click on download firmware over here. You can see everything else has been detected. If I click on download firmware, it's not going to open because I don't have a drone connected. Okay, so what you can do, and it's quite simple, you just open your browser and you start typing in dank drone. I'll just move my mouse up the way here quickly. Dank drone downloader. And once you open this website, you should be able to select whatever drone you want. In this case, DJI. I'm gonna select my goggles and you can see there's lots of firmware for you here. Unfortunately, dronehacks will not allow you to flash your air units and those goggles or V1 goggles at the same time. It is only here for the DJI FPV Racer goggles. So that's GL17 goggles. Okay, so if I select that one, you can see that I am able to select whichever firmware I wanna be on. Now I know I'm on this firmware version. So let me just select the latest version over here. I'm gonna select other because there's no category. Click submit and I'll click download. There the file's going to download. Luckily my internet connection is quite fast today, so I can just grab that from there. Okay, so I've put the goggle firmware version onto the latest into my dronehacks folder. And what I can do is I can just click on the browse button. I can click on my desktop, where did I put it? And here we go, got my dronehacks folder and there's the firmware. So over here, I can now select open and you can just see firmware has a lower anti-rollback value and the drone, as the drone or the goggles in this case, you need to downgrade via an export. Now there are no exports for these goggles, meaning that you can. So if you are on this firmware version, you will not be able to downgrade the goggles or even upgrade the goggles. Okay, now remember, you can also go into your goggles and you can switch between air unit mode essentially and the DJI FPV Racer or system. And you need to be in the DJI FPV Racer system for this to work. So in this case, I'm gonna unplug this one, turn this goggles off. And now I'm gonna go to an older set. Now, why am I showing you guys how to upgrade this? Okay, well, there might be a reason that you want to upgrade your firmware. There might be something wrong with your goggles, especially for instance, for those of you guys that have random blackouts while you're flying, upgrading your firmware will solve that problem. But remember, you've got to flash the DJI FPV side and you've got to flash the air unit side. But in this case, let me just plug in this goggle over here and I'll show you exactly why it's necessary to upgrade the goggles. This is my FPV set, okay? I've used this with my air units and I don't want to upgrade it because I still want to root this in the future. But if you have a DJI FPV Racer drone, you're going to get an error message in your goggles once you've done the mod on the dronehacks website. Now remember, if you're on the dronehacks website and you have updated your, you've bought a license and you've updated your FPV Racer drone to the recommended firmware, or essentially downgraded your firmware, you're able then to initiate the signal hacking, no-fly zones and altitude limits can be removed. However, for this to work, and this is specifically for the DJI FPV Racer, you will need to have your goggles on the latest version. Once again, doesn't detect. Let me just quickly unplug and plug it back in again. Just good to see if it can detect it. Sometimes when you see it doesn't connect to the PC, you might want to power cycle your goggles. So if you get to this point, you know that your goggles can detect because your PC is picking it up. However, you can see dronehacks has not detected it at all. Something is not right. Okay, well, you've got to switch over to the digital FPV side. So you've got to switch over. Let me just flip it over. In the goggles, just gonna quickly go to the settings. You go to the settings tab in your goggles, you scroll all the way down to device. Unfortunately, I can't show you guys this, but there's an option for you to switch over to the DJI FPV system. Okay, so I've selected the button and now I can just restart my goggles. And then just power them up again. I should now be in the DJI FPV system mode, meaning that it should detect by dronehacks now. I am now in DJI FPV mode. So let me just disconnect this from the computer. I'll connect it back in again. We're just waiting for dronehacks to detect it. If it doesn't detect it over here, as you guys can see, for some reason it hasn't picked it up. I know it's picked it up because my USB flash drive is now detected. I'm just going to disconnect or close dronehacks and then reopen dronehacks. So there we go, searching for the device. And you can see there, my drone, my goggles have now connected and my version is still nice and old. Okay, so in this scenario, you can see once again, I can't update my drone because I've got goggles connected. But if I go to the flash firmware option, I'm now able to select the firmware. Just quickly find on my desktop again. There we go. And I'm now able to flash, as you can see there. Anti-rollback values are identical, flashing is possible. All you do now is you click the flash button and you can essentially upgrade your goggles. Now, I don't want to upgrade my goggles because I still want to have the root exploit in the future. But in this case, if you guys needed to upgrade your firmware, you would just click the flash button and you would essentially flash it. It would ask you, at the end, it would ask you to restart it and then you would have your confirmation over here on the current firmware that your firmware has been updated. Once again, guys, this is mainly for the guys with the DJI FPV drone, but for those of you guys that have a DJI air unit and you're flying and you've got some issues with your goggles that are randomly restarting, then you can go and flash the DJI goggle version, the Vista version, and essentially what happens is that you get the same version of your air unit onto your DJI FPV side. And the reason you want to do that is purely because then the firmware will work. When you flash the air unit side and you don't flash the DJI side, then sometimes there's some guys that have experienced some blackouts. You just fly and then randomly it will cut out. Upgrading to the latest version in dronehacks or version 20 or any of the firmware, actually you can just reflash any of the firmware, that should resolve the issue for you. Okay, this is just a quick little video. A little bit longer than I wanted to, but yeah, if you find this video useful, please click the like button and subscribe. Also, take a look at the affiliate links down below. It really does help out the channel.